talking one of the best, if not the best promoter in boxing, Eddie Hearn, fresh from his big night in boxing, Devin Haney.
Yeah,
how good did that kid look?
Unbelievable. I mean, you know, you get the negativity, oh, how good was Abdullah, but it's the level that, and the way that he's dealing with these people. Like, he's making them look so ordinary. And what amazes me is at 20 years of age, does that sound all right for you?
Yeah.
At 20 years of age, like, he's ring IQ, his maturity in the ring, his feet, everything. So it's just amazing to watch, really. It's also his work ethic. Anyone's been around him, I'm sure you've seen him in the gyms over the years. Like,
amazing.
I've not seen that. A lot of fighters work hard. This guy's on another level. And I always say as well that Bill Haney, your father involved in a career, 9 times out of 10 is not a good thing. But Bill does such an amazing job with him, and they bounce off each other, and you know, it's just it's an honour to represent him, really is. And I truly believe he's going to go on and become a full, proper WBC world champion.
So yesterday, Ryan Garcia was supposed to fight. His opponent gets arrested.
Yeah.
That rarely happens, that they get arrested before. They usually get arrested after.
Yeah.
What do you make of the whole situation? Have you been following it on social media?
Yeah, I mean, look, I don't want to start, like, hey, Hayden, I don't really want to start, you know, taking dicks and swipes at people. There's enough people doing that already. Do you know what I mean? So I've just been watching it unfold like everybody else. It's been like a mini documentary series, you know, over the last sort of 24 hours. I don't know the ins and outs. I mean, normally, if you find out something like that earlier in the week and you've got someone on the card as important as Ryan Garcia, you'd have a backup in plan. Maybe they did. Maybe it was that Duno guy. I don't know. But I don't think everything seems great there anyway. So this has just added another problem to that relationship, and I hope everybody works it out.
Now, I talked to Mikey this week. You were just texting him when I was talking to him.
Yeah, yeah.
Anything new with Mikey? Is it going?
No, I think he wants to see if he can get a Pacquiao fight. And I said to him, if you get that fight, that's a great fight for you. You know, I can't expect you to not take the Pacquiao fight over a fight that I'm offering. So really, the fights that I'm going to be offering him now because of our schedule are more like January and February next year. So I don't know whether he wants to wait that long or whether he's looking. I don't think Pacquiao's going to fight till next year anyway. So I don't know. Sometimes people get sort of lured in by, oh, I can get you this fight, I'll get you Pacquiao, I can get this. So we'll see what the truth is. I think a lot of the platforms right now are kind of getting congested, and some of the promises they're making are either not coming true or they're taking longer to, you know, to make happen. So
now, you went to Saudi Arabia,
yeah.
You went to New York, London, the whole
yeah.
world's so excited for the rematch.
Yeah.
What do you tell people? Andy Ruiz, Joshua? Most people at this point have Andy Ruiz as the favorite.
Really? Yeah, I have Joshua as a slight favorite, but it's very difficult because obviously Ruiz just won the first fight and won it by stopping. So I just see a different Anthony Joshua this time around. You know, I see a guy that's much more motivated. Not that he didn't want to win last time, but he really wanted to beat Jarrell Miller up, and then it's like a pin got put in him when that fight fell out. And I don't think he really got himself up for the Ruiz fight, and Ruiz was the better man on the night. So it's going to be a different fight this time around. It's going to be epic. It's going to be the biggest fight of the year. December 7th, we can't wait, live on the zone.
Last night, you and Big Baby together in the same place.
Yeah,
who would have thought?
I saw him. Well, I see him over in the corner, and I was like, he was like, you know, texting me. And then we came to the press conference after. I like the guy, you know? Like, and actually, for the first time last night, he actually said, we all make mistakes. I did something stupid. I listened to people I shouldn't have. Blah, blah. That's really what I wanted to hear. You know, I don't want to hear, oh, you don't know the full story. Oh, father this, father that. No, no. You failed on 3 substances with 3 symptoms. Just say, I was an idiot. Someone told me I could get away with it. And I did it, and I regret it for the rest of my life. That's cool. And then take your licks, and then you can come back. Like going to prison, you know? Like, you commit a crime. Pay your dues.
You get a second chance.
Yeah, to a certain level, unless the crime is too horrific, you should never be allowed to come back. But you know, in this is a situation for me where it's like, you made a mistake, pay your dues. You know, but the problem is, there's no dues to pay. There's no American governing body that go, right, Jarrell Miller, this is happening to you, you're banned for a year, right? If that happened, then he served his ban for a year, I'd almost be okay to say, all right, you made a mistake, I believe you realise that mistake, you can go again. But now it's like it was in June or May. I mean, like, we're only just turned September.
That's
true. Okay now. So how's that putting fighters off cheating? Because there's too much cheating going on in America as it is.
That's true. But he's back. He's available. We'll see what he's doing next. But you said you offered Tank $10 million? Because Taker's
fight. No, he asked for 10 million.
Okay, and what did you say?
So I offered 5, and I was probably going to go up from there. But he went and moved to lightweight, and he vacated his belt. So
that fight's
looks
over.
Like it. Maybe we'll do the Haney fight now.
Who, what do you think? Devin Haney?
Tank, yes.
Gervonta Davis?
Big fight. I mean, they've sparred many rounds. Two brilliant young fighters, you know, and I'd love to see Haney versus anyone. You know, I believe in him so much, and he believes in himself so much that he's willing to fight all these guys.
Anything new with Kell Brook?
He's back in training. You know, he's got a lot of weight to shift, but he's in that process. So he's looking for a fight December time, and he wants some big fights. You know, he wanted to fight Terence Crawford. I see a couple of back and forwards between them. I don't think that fight's going. I think he's going to fight Kavalauskas. But, you know, Kell Brook is ready for those big fights, and at this stage in his career, that's all he wants.
I have to ask you this question. Devin Haney called out Loma. A lot of people gave him a hard time, but a fighter should call out the best.
Mandatory. You know, like he wanted to become mandatory. So I even said to him, look, we want to take Abdullah, but he's a little bit unknown. He's quite, I've heard good
very talented. I saw him train, and he was very impressive in the gym. I have to tell people, he was
people
dominating.
People now say, no, Abdullah.
No, he was the real deal just last week.
So, but before the fight, everyone's going, whoa, this Abdullah, he's dangerous. And then Haney does that, and they go, nah, Abdullah's rubbish. So, but I said to him, you know, realise that Lomachenko's probably not going to fight you, so do you want to chase him? Yeah, I want Lomachenko. You know, he's the best. I want to fight the best, and that's what I want to do. So give him props for doing that. Don't criticise him. For, if you think he's out of his depth, that's what he said last night. If you think I'm too green, fight me now. He's only going to get better. He's 20 years old.
Yeah.
Imagine how good he's going to be at 23, 24. You know?
Most people only turn pro at this point.
Oh, well, we've got loads of kids, 19, 20, just turning pro. Well, they're 2-3-0. 24-0, number one in the world, interim world champion.
With skills.
Oh, now, unbelievable.
Canelo Kovalev.
Yeah.
You're taking it. It's on the zone,
it's
of course.
It's a good fight. I think it's a really good fight. I think it's intriguing. I mean, probably lost a little bit of edge because of Kovalev's last performance. But, you know, Kovalev is a big light heavyweight. And Canelo is a small middleweight. So, you know, in that respect, I think it's going to be super exciting. I think Canelo wins by stoppage.
And Canelo,
I think it's like the last sort of cash-out fight for Kovalev. But he'll give it everything. He's a tough guy, and I think he's a very intriguing fight.
Now, Eddie, in the last 9 months, you took something that didn't exist, that people said will never work,
yeah,
and you've signed, you have Canelo, you have Joshua, you have Andy Ruiz, Joshua too, you have Devin Haney,
Golovkin.
Usyk, by the way,
Andrade.
Crazy. Andrade, what's the next move, by the way?
Just spoke to him yesterday. I'd like him to go on the Canelo-Kovalev card, really.
That'll be huge.
But obviously, Golden Boy would have to approve that, so we'll see if those conversations with the zone can move anywhere, and yeah, I think that's a good look for him. I mean, look, I've got three fighters in Billy Joe, Callum Smith, and Demetrius, who no one really wants to fight because they're too good or too dangerous. So I'm kind of like, guys, do you want to just fight each other? Do you know what I mean?
That would be huge. Yeah. Now, speaking of this is another revolutionary thing that you're doing. Some people love you for it, some people criticize you. Two guys that were never pro, but are crazy popular. One has 20 million followers. Right. You're bringing them into boxing. Eddie, tell me about how this came along. KSI,
well, they've done it for themselves. I mean, you know, I was asked last time around to get involved in this. And I tried to, as a hardcore boxing fan, as someone that loves this sport, probably as much as anyone watching this video, I was like, nah, no way, that's not for me. You know, who even are these guys? Like, I wasn't that familiar with the YouTube setup, you know. And people were saying to me, no, these guys are huge, you've got to understand that. And I said, look, where's it happening? Manchester Arena. I started laughing. I said, it's the biggest arena in England. Well, they're mad. Who's broadcasting it? It's on pay-per-view. Pay-per-view. Anyway, lo and behold, a few weeks later, they sell 20,000 tickets. They do 1.3 million pay-per-view buyers.
A lot of illegal streams.
Yeah, and I have to say, the fight was really good. Like, it was, of course, it wasn't a world-class fight, but it wasn't like two guys playing around. They were both in shape. So they came to me about the second fight. Obviously, I felt like it was great for DAZN in terms of the audience, in terms of the way people were digesting content for a streaming platform. But I said to the guys, I'm going to get loads of stick for this, right? So the only way I feel we can do it is if you respect the code of the sport. And what that means is you've got to turn pro, so no one can mock you for it. You've got to lose the head guards. And the managers were like, no, they've got to have the head guards. I went, no. And you've got to wear 10-ounce gloves. I said, because I tell you now, someone's getting knocked out. 100%. you see the shots they took in the first fight? No head guards and 10-ounce gloves. No one standing at the end of these six rounds. I promise you that. So now we've actually got a good fight. But let's use this audience to try and get them to become fans of boxing.
That'll be huge.
And like, but people already, like DeBella was saying last night, look, I, you know, lose a friend of mine. Oh, I don't think that the audience will stick into boxing. Well, it will if you show them what we see, what we love. So put Devin Haney on the card, put Billy Joe Saunders, put great fighters on the card. So the 20,000 in Staples and the millions watching around the world go, oh man, that Devin Haney, I love Devin Haney. You know, I mean, how many people are going to watch this fight worldwide? I don't know. 50 million, right? Time it's said and done. Those people, if 1% can translate into Devin Haney fans or Billy Joe fans, I'm the happiest man alive.
Not only that, but if you never watch boxing like this, you get bitten by the bug and you get the atmosphere. Atmosphere of a boxing event is like none other.
No, exactly. So we fell for it, so why shouldn't they? You know, people sometimes behave like that. Those their fans are not human. Do you know what I mean? We're human. We touch boxing and we fell in love with it. So why can't these people do it if we show them what we love about it, you know? So
I will tell you this, Eddie. Lomachenko fighting your guy Campbell.
Yeah.
Usyk going. It's worldwide. Every gym I go to is packed right now. Boxing is a very good place. Yeah. A lot of people are getting into the sport. An event like this could bring in a whole tsunami of fans that never...
But in the gyms, going to live fights, watching on TV.
Yeah, following. Yeah.
Everything. And, you know, like these guys, they're not idiots. They're very bright people. You know, I mean, you understand the YouTube world and stuff like that. You must look at their numbers and just go, fuck. But like, I saw the other day, he posted something about he's doing like pretending to DJ on some bottle tops. It's like 8 million views or something like that. I mean, you know, so I just think it's brilliant. And people like Devin, he understands it. He's like, they asked him last night, oh, do you not feel like that's a bit of a, you know, kick in the nuts to go on that card? He's like, are you joking? Like, if I can get that audience.
Of course.
Mega.
It's a win.
Yeah.
So my last two questions. Mikey Garcia, if he fights Pacquiao, what's your take? Pacquiao looked great his last fight.
It's
Mikey's
a really good fight. You know,
they sparred in the past?
Yeah, look, Pacquiao's not a huge 47, so I think that's where Mikey struggles, particularly like against Errol Spence. So I think that's a good fight. I rate Mikey Garcia. I think he's a wonderful fighter, and Manny Pacquiao seems to be getting better and better somehow.
And my last question, who does the winner... There's no third fight with Joshua Ruiz. Yeah. What does the winner do?
Well, we go back to searching for that undisputed, but...